Hi guys, my name is Sila Ajiban and welcome to my channel. Oh, yes, welcome to my new channel. This is the Sila Ajiban Show. I'm joking, but yeah, no, I really wanted to just make my own channel. You may or may not know, I have a family YouTube channel called Meet the BAs. It's me, my husband, our twin sons, and sometimes our eldest son might be in it as well. So yeah, check it out. That's All Stuff Family. We've kind of given the channel to the kids now, so they do like toy unboxings, maybe might do some family day vlogs over there. So if you like that type of thing, feel free to check that out. I just kind of wanted a platform that was just for me to kind of talk about the things that I go through. I'm a mum, I'm a wife, I'm an entrepreneur, I run a business with my husband. So it's a lot of things I feel like I deal with, and I just want one central place that can just talk about everything and share my journey. I do have a mum platform on Instagram, it's called Mums That Meet, and through that platform, sharing my journey has not only helped other women, but it's really helped me. And in fact, it helps me the most, I guess, because I feel like just putting stuff out there, just hearing from other people that you're not the only one that goes through stuff and all those types of things, it is just really helpful. So I just wanted one place that I can talk about all those stuff that I mentioned and just feel like me, basically. And on top of that, my life coach said that I'm really good on camera, and she says that I'm good on videos, so blame her. I just wanted to just take the leap and just thought, you know what, why not? Let's just do it. So to get this first video started, I thought about doing something different and do like a new YouTuber get to know me tag. I found it on Google, it's got some questions, so I'm gonna ask myself some of those questions and let you guys get to know me a little bit more. Okay, so I'm gonna give you a little intro on me. So like I said, I'm a mum, so I have twin sons. Azariah and Micah, they are 4 years old. I can't believe they're four. Wow. Becoming a mum was a big thing for me. I lost my identity. It was a shock to the system. I never expected it.
I never expected it, but God gave it to me.
So I guess that's kind of even brought me to be the woman I am today and all these different types of stuff. So I definitely be talking a lot of motherhood stuff on this channel. Being a mum, juggling and all that type of stuff. As I said, I run a business with my husband, and that, like, well, running a business anyway, being an entrepreneur, comes with its own ups and downs and all of that stuff. And I feel like this would be a good place to talk about that as well. So I'll definitely be talking about my journey of being an entrepreneur, and then also my journey of working with my husband, which is a whole thing that I didn't expect it to be what it was. Let's just say that. And I've learned so much by doing it. I'm still learning, in fact. So definitely we'll be talking about that and what it's like. And I might even get him on a few videos to kind of even talk about that together and how we kind of manage all of that. And like I just said, I have a husband, so I'm married. And even like the journey to getting married, being married, I've learned so much about myself being married. Like, yeah. It's been so eye-opening, and that's something I really want to talk about as well. So as you can hear, like, there's loads of avenues I feel like and journeys I go through, and I just really want to be able to share my journey with other women to be able to help them and help myself. And I did say that I was going to do like this little YouTuber tag to let you guys get to know me a little bit more. So I will look at some of these questions and maybe answer them. So what inspired you to start making videos? Now, I tell you what, right? I basically had like an awakening. It was so weird. Like, we registered our business in 2020, well, now, this year, April this year. It doesn't feel like it. It feels like we've been doing it for so long. But yeah, we registered it this year, April, and I'll be honest, I'll talk about it later on, but I lost myself when I had the twins. I lost myself again when we started the business. And I just kind of got to a point where I was like, well, I say like it was all me. It definitely was not all me. My husband was also like, I feel like you're losing yourself. I feel like you don't do any stuff for you anymore and all that type of stuff. And yeah, he was right. And I was talking to some other people and they'll ask me, oh, how's Mum's That Meat going and all that stuff? Or how's the podcast? I have a podcast too. That's a Mum's That Meat podcast. So anybody that wants to listen to it, I'm going to put all of this stuff in the description box so you can check out the platforms and the podcast and all that stuff. But yeah, people would ask me about that and I wouldn't have any answers to them because I haven't done anything. I don't post on the platform no more. I don't make podcast episodes no more. I just stopped because I was focusing on the business, and running a business, as anyone who runs a business out there, you would know, is very challenging. And it comes with its own financial constraints. And I'll be honest, when we started it, I guess we kind of thought we was like ready to go. I don't think we was ready to go, I'll be honest. So it has definitely been a roller coaster, and we've been in survival mode, right? And it's been a lot of feast to famine, which is basically like one month you're making loads of money, things are going really well, and then the next month things are much quieter than before. So it's a lot to deal with, as well as doing all the other stuff for myself. So yeah, but anyway, my husband was saying all this to me, people would ask me questions, so many things would just happen, and then I just there was a day, I don't know what it was, and I was like, I can't do this no more. I cannot do this where my life is only business. I need some Scylla back in my life. So this is where my YouTube channel came from. So I basically am here to have a bit of Scylla, have a bit of me back. You know, like I said, I'm going to talk about my journey of all this different stuff, but ultimately I just want a bit of me time. This is some taking time out for myself. I enjoy doing stuff like this. I hope to build a community of women through this, so then I can have other women and make some friends that kind of go through what I go through too. So yeah, that's kind of how that's how I was inspired to start making these videos. This is random. This is a random one. How many siblings do you have? So funnily enough, I actually have 3, 6. I think I have 6 siblings. 6. Yeah, I have 6 and I'm the baby out of all of them. The reason why I was confused is my dad has children and then obviously my mum has children. So that's why I was like, but yeah, I'm the youngest for my mum and my dad. So yeah, youngest out of 7. I won't lie, although I have all those siblings, I still very much felt like an only child growing up. Sorry to my siblings out there, except for my sister. My sister, a lot of my siblings didn't live in the same country as me. My sister joined us when I was, I think, 10 or something. No, that's a lie. When I was a bit younger, I don't remember the age. But so for a long part of my life, I felt like an only child. And me and my sister do have a massive age gap of 10 years. So it does also feel like, if anybody's got older siblings, you know what it's like. They don't really feel like a sibling. They feel more like a parent, especially with that age gap. It's only now as adults that we're actually building our own friendship and it feels like I've got a sister. But yeah, so I'm a baby of the family, but a baby that kind of feels like the old eldest child. I see all these tweets about what the eldest child deals with, and I feel like I'm not far off it, because like I said, it was just me and my mum in the country. My sister was here for a big part. I think she was here for about 10 years and then she moved to America. So then, yeah, it's back to just me again. So yeah, waffling a little bit on that one, but yeah, baby of 7. How tall are you? I'm gonna answer this one because no one ever expects my height when they see pictures of me, that's when they see me in real life. So I'm actually 5'10 and a half. Yeah. I'm a giant, a female giant. And yeah, I'm tall. And so tall that when I went to China, they thought I was Naomi Campbell. Everybody wanted to stop to take photos of me. Well, actually, that's a lie. They didn't think I was Naomi Campbell. They thought I was some sort of supermodel because I was tall. And apparently back then they didn't see many tall black women. So they kept stopping me for photos and all that type of stuff. And yeah, I told them I'm Naomi Campbell. Here on a shoot. So I'm probably on a mantelpiece in a Chinese home somewhere of the day they met Naomi Campbell, but it was me. So if you ever do come across this YouTube channel, I'm sorry, I'm not Naomi Campbell. How often will you upload videos for your viewers? Do I want to answer this question? I struggle to be consistent with anything, I can't lie, but I'm making a promise to myself to be consistent to this. So I will say at least every 2 weeks. So hopefully, yeah, we'll get a video from me every 2 weeks. And yeah, like I said, I'm gonna be talking about a lot of the stuff that I go through as a mum, a wife, an entrepreneur, just the woman in general. So if there is any conversations anybody wants me to talk about, like any of those, any topics around those things anyone wants me to talk about, I'm happy to do so. Feel free to put in the comments below. All right, so I feel like I'm waffling a little bit now, so I think I'm gonna start wrapping this up. So yeah, thank you so much for watching this video. Please feel free to subscribe to my channel. Feel free to follow me on Instagram as well, at Sila Adjumang. Like I said, I've got a mum platform at mums.me for mums that want to help build their confidence, find their passion and their purpose, all that type of stuff. That also has a podcast. I'm gonna add all of this. I'll probably add some of it to the screen and I'll add all of it into the description. But yeah, guys, just join me on my journey, and thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys soon.